What's going on, everybody? Welcome to Brutal Planet Comics. I'm your host, Trey DeBrute Daniels. Here with some more news. Happy Monday to you all. Oh, duh, lolly. The great Disney purge continues. Earlier this week, we thought ESPN was going to be the main sacrifice. Oh, no, 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 no. Now Disney Plus leadership are getting the axe. Oh, my God. Look at that stock drop. Jesus Christ. So let's jump right into the meat and potatoes and figure out what's going down. Okay, in its latest quarter, streaming losses narrowed to $1.1 billion in quarter one from $1.5 billion in quarter four. Ahead of the company's previous guidance, still, losses were up compared to the year-ago period when direct-to-consumer losses totaled $593 million. Iger reaffirmed the company's outlook of reaching streaming profitability by the year 2024. Oh my, let's look at this little map here. Man, products revenue, good grief. Well, man, so streaming is failing Disney because everybody's checking out because the content is subpar for the overwhelming majority. And now they're hemorrhaging money. They're hemorrhaging billions. This is tough. So let's just figure out what Bob Iger did here. Okay, Iger's streaming reset comes as the executive has stressed a direct link between content decisions and financial performance. Really? You don't say? Oh my God. Especially amid a challenging macroeconomic environment that's pressured other media giants. Really?
You're so dumb.
Like Warner Bros. Discovery and Paramount Global to enact their own cost-saving initiatives. This is a time of enormous change and challenges in our industry, he wrote in an internal memo at the time of DMED's restructuring. Our work will also focus on creating a more efficient and cost-effective structure. The executive has since kept up with his promise, restructuring the organization into three core business segments: Disney Entertainment, ESPN, and Disney Parks, Experience and Products. The company will break out those segments for the first time next month when it reports quarterly earnings on May 10th. Oh my goodness. So everybody's head is rolling. So he's just fusing a whole bunch of things together. Let's look back at that graph real quick. So now all these squares that we have here are all being minimalized. So we have product revenue, media entertainment, park experience, consumer, operating income. So this is all being simplified into three major groups now, which I think is a smart move. But at this point, who gives a crap if your product still sucks? It doesn't matter. Like he said, if it's not up to par, it's not up to par. It's over. It's over.
Only now, at the end, do you understand?
So ultimately, what do I think about this? Yeah, of course I saw this coming. Of course Disney Plus is about to take a hit. I know its executives have already been fired already the moment Bob Iger came back. I know these things already. This is not... the fact of the matter is that now all the dominoes are falling and we're all supposed to be shocked at this. I'm not. Now, the problem, once again, I feel sorry for the working class folks that are suffering because of this and this downsizing. Once again, they're going to take a major hit and a lot of good people are going to lose their jobs, and that freaking sucks. They haven't hit their 7,000 firings yet, so who knows? Who knows who else could get me on the chopping block? Some regular 9-to-5 that's got nothing to do with these problems. So, but Disney Plus needs to take a hit anyway. It has not turned a profit since its inception. It's hemorrhaging billions, as we've seen. It's time for all of this to take a hit. What do you guys think about this? Let me know in the comment section below. And do all those great YouTube things. Like, comment, subscribe, and share the video. As always, you guys have been awesome. I'll catch you all next time. Also, if you want to support my channel, check out SpinWiz.com or download the SpinWiz app and check out my comic series, Trouble. It was written with a lot of love, and it was definitely my favorite comic series to write. I've also written it in English and in Spanish, so whatever floats your boat, I got it for you. Thanks again, and check it out.